You should probably turn to your listening partner at this point. Get your listener pad out as well if you've been making notes this morning on this special day, the Great Leader's Day. And take this in, because what we do is after every programme we have a listener meeting and just work out how you guys are doing, where you're going wrong, all that kind of stuff. And we do, generally, don't we, on a Friday, Dave, we do the main listener meeting.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it today, actually.
Absolutely, I can't wait for that. And what happens as well is we're sometimes observed by Tim Lihoreau from Classic FM, who started to commission and produce, and entirely pay for, self-funded, little documentaries all about us and the important broadcast here on XFM. So this is kind of completing the trilogy so far, and it's Tim's look behind the scenes at what goes on post-show.
It's 10:10 on Friday morning. The last important broadcast of the week has been delivered from Studio XFM to a grateful public. And it's time for Danny, Dave and Matt to begin their weekly listener meeting.
Okay, let's start with confirmed listener Fran. How did he do this week?
Yeah, some progress. Nice contributions on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday.
Okay, Wednesday?
I didn't see anything from him on Wednesday.
Mm. Was there a note?
Nothing on file.
I've got nothing.
Downstairs in an office close to the Global Radio Exercise Yard, work experience Steve is hitting the phones, chasing the truants.
Hi, is that confirmed listener Alan?
Yeah, we didn't get anything from you this morning. The texter was animals that look like Napoleon?
I see. Well, how do you expect to learn anything if you don't join in?
I wouldn't say I respect the listeners.
Presenter of the year, Danny Wallace.
Some of them are absolute clowns. You know, ideally they should be listening at their tables in complete silence. If they're in transit, we do give them enough time to bring their vehicles to a complete stop, obviously. But if they don't stop in time, I just consider that simply purifying the listener base. With quality morning broadcasting, there will be casualties. It's just a fact.
Well, Danny said we should provide diagrams with each listener pad for correct listener posture, and we took that feedback on board.
Producer Dave Masterman.
Straight back, shut mouth, pad on knees, pen in hand, ready access to fluids, and the bedpans really just in case an important pronouncement happens at an inopportune moment.
The XFM Confirmed Listener Act of 2012 allows Danny to take decisive action when expected levels of quality are not met. Head of Listener Relations, Simon Fowler.
I wouldn't say it's the best part of my job, but it has to be done. Oh, hi, is that Sam in Brixton? Yeah, just to say, I'm afraid we're going to have to let you go. You know, no, I know, look, yeah, I know, look, you've had a good run, we just feel it's time for you to move on, you know, in the long run, you'll thank us. You're not really keeping up, are you?
Listener workshops take place each Friday afternoon at the Crawley Community Arts and Yoga Therapy Centre, formerly Spangles Nightclub.
Study your notes. Consult your pads. If you're late tuning in, the running order and rules are published each morning in the London Gazette. Repeat after me. Remain docile.
Remain docile. Remain docile.
Ultimately, I live and breathe XFM, and that's what I want the listeners to do as well. You know, in an ideal world, I'd sit down in my XFM t-shirt on my XFM rug, drinking from my XFM mug of XFM beer. I'd order an XFM curry, maybe a cheeky bottle of XFM wine, and I'd listen to Capital.
And it's that level of serious dedication the great leader expects from his listeners.
Ultimately, as Danny often says, there's a time and a place for fun and laughter, and it is not the XFM Breakfast Show with Danny Wallace.
So I hope you've made the appropriate notes and maybe learnt something.
XFM.